Do you need errors and omissions insurance, general liability, drone insurance, or even cyber liability coverage? Then let me tell you about our sponsor, Claim Professionals Liability Insurance Company, or CPLIC. Founded 16 years ago by independent adjusters for independent adjusters, CPLIC offers products to give you peace of mind while you help your insureds. Apply for coverage now at cplic.net and let them know that Adjuster TV sent you.
And so they're really competing for customer base based on experience of the claims. And so when they do have claims, they want to make sure that the experience is really there. And so our technology, what we heard, is really not there to automate anything. It's not there to, say, take anyone's job. It's there to allow the people that know how to do their job best make better decisions faster and be able to go on to the next claim.
Adjusters, have you ever had a contractor get in your face about adding line items to your estimate because they're required by code? In this video, Garrett Kurt, the CEO and founder of a very interesting company called One Click Code, visited us at our Montana Adjuster TV studios and talks about how his app can not only save you up to an hour or more chasing down the latest building code info, but also puts the brakes on debates about codes, starting now.
You're watching the Property IA Show.
Hey, it's Matt here with the Property IA Show on Adjuster TV. And for the best tips and tools for getting on the first call list as an independent adjuster, subscribe to Adjuster TV here on YouTube. Click on the bell notification so that you never miss a video. And you can hit the like button too. Go on, hit it. What is One Click Code and how can it help you save hours of time when you're handling property claims? I'll let Garrett explain.
Imagine that if you could actually take the Google search and be able to type in an address, and it would magically know that you were an adjuster or a contractor, and it would give you all the key information that you needed as an adjuster to write an accurate and defendable estimate. That is One Click Code, yeah. My name is Garrett. I'm the founder and CEO of One Click Code. We are an all-digital platform that takes building codes across the United States, and we aggregate them into an easy and understandable report that is address specific. So One Click Code was, you know, the brainchild of myself probably about 5 years ago. After being an adjuster and contractor for 12 years, I felt like there was things that just kept on happening over and over again. And it was patterns. Sometimes those patterns are really blatantly obvious. For me, they were blatantly painful. And what was so painful was us trying to, as a contractor, trying to take the building codes in these thick books, take photocopies of the pages, right? And then you would put them together and combine them in PDF. And then you have to highlight them, right? And you would send it off to the adjuster and it would be like, you know, 10 pages long. And now as an adjuster, when I received those, it was very painful because every time I had to read that, I didn't know what I was supposed to look for. And if I knew if I put that in the file, it would be for surely gonna be QA'd. And then they go, what is this? And where is the information that supports the line item? So it was a nonstop battle. I'm trying to both create a diplomatic type approach of being able to work together with, as an adjuster or contractor, being able to document those codes in a very meaningful way. And I thought there's gonna be a better way to do it. And that's how I came up with the idea, like, if someone's gonna do it, it's gonna be me. So far we started off, it would have been, we launched nationwide last July. Prior to that, we were only in Colorado and Texas, which is pretty big markets for us. However, our adoption rate was quite low. We saw a substantial adoption in July and August of last year. What we were not really prepared for was the inundation of 2020. We saw more carriers, more staff adjusters, more IAs, more contractors. In fact, in a 3-month period during coronavirus, we saw 3,000 people sign up for our app organically. And we started to see that our reports were being accepted by carriers and used by contractors and adjusters to essentially settle claims. And so we started for the first time noticing that claims were being settled with our reports in it. It's pretty cool. And so the adoption was slow, but it was like a hockey stick. And right now we're riding that hockey stick. What people would love to believe that it's automated, both on our end, but it's not, it's manual. We're doing the same thing that adjusters and contractors do. We're calling those cities and counties, but we just do it, instead of once or twice, we're doing it 3 times a year. And so we know based on our own research, we know when building codes are going to change. And so we do not scrape websites because ultimately websites are never up to date. Some of the counties and cities haven't done their updates for years. And so how are you reliant on that? And if you call, you could actually talk to somebody that has no authority, that has no idea, that's just started working or has been there forever and they didn't know the codes changed. So what we do is we have multiple people call multiple times a year to confirm what we already have confirmed, to confirm what we already confirmed, because so many people are relying on us. I believe that we save anywhere from 20 minutes to an hour of legwork. It could be higher, up to 2 hours over the whole entire duration. If you think about it from an initial inspection, if an adjuster has the authority to pay for the code items up front, they may go do that research. The first thing before you go for the building code research, you have to know what the authority, who has the permitting authority. A little known fact, and I think a lot of the adjusters will find this, is, and contractors too, but most people don't know that every single property in the United States is assigned a U.S. postal address. U.S. postal addresses have no indication of jurisdiction whatsoever. Jurisdiction is a fancy word for saying permitting authority, right? Who's going to enforce these codes? Zip codes run through multiple cities and multiple counties. So you can't use zip code. And cities are assigned to every single property in the United States, regardless whether they're in that city or in a city. And it's pretty obvious when you're sitting out in the middle of a cornfield and you're like, well, it's obviously not in, you know, Broomfield, right? But when you're in the metropolitan area and you're driving from one job to the other or one claim to the other, you're watching Google Maps and Google Maps doesn't tell you, is it really in that city or not? And so that's the jurisdiction. So unincorporated townships, unincorporated counties, that's what we solidify first. And that's the one thing. And if you look at the data, if you looked at just the city and an address, you would be wrong on the building codes 45% of the time, because 45% of the properties fall outside of the city in which they listed, which is crazy. So if you think about it, really think about it, even if we were able to automate the building codes and having this amazing database, we would be wrong 45% of the time. Would that be acceptable within the insurance industry? Absolutely not. So that was the first thing we had to figure out, the database. That was painstakingly hard to figure out how to get all that data and keep on getting it, but we did both. You really want to be able to be as accurate as possible for multiple reasons. One of them is compliance, you know, with the states. Different states have different compliance. You should be estimating for what you know at the time of the loss, right? Everything. You estimate for sales tax. You could technically estimate for the permit value. Not everybody does that, but you could. And if you know the permit value, you probably should be putting in there. And in building codes, it's the same thing. Just like you know, like there's X amount of square feet of a roof and it's a certain amount of material. If you know it, you're going to put it in there. And so what building codes are sometimes things that people know that should be in an estimate, and they're not actually putting them in there. In my opinion, it's not good because it's not allowing a very quick and precise adjustment process and allow the adjuster to do what they know best, which is adjust claims, estimate losses, get on to the next thing. And I think what you can do as an adjuster is if you have the authority to do so, you include as many things up front as possible. It reduces the chance of a reinspection. It reduces the chance of a QA on the back, and it reduces your file being reopened again. Because what I found across the country is the pattern is, it's a dispute over price. You can use all the estimating programs you want, Symbility, Xactimate. It's still user input, right? And what are we arguing about at the end? It's really about the price. You know, we use line items as a way to describe our feelings of the price not being right, but it's just a price. You know, it comes down to it. And so we're really arguing about price. Either way, I'm defending it on an adjustment side of saying my price is right because I'm accurate. And the contractor's saying, this is my price because that's what I charge. But we're using the same programs, which is called Xactimate. So we have been talking to a lot of different parties within the insurance industry, carriers, investment arms of the carriers. Our product is very interesting to them in terms of helping both, not necessarily automate, it's about giving a decision instantly to allow an adjuster to be able to make the right choice when entering line items. It's kind of like what we're finding is that they're looking for foundational things or tech that's easy, they call it low code, and fast implementation, right? So it's low IT, they can implement it fast, and they don't have a high training cost to be able to implement it. They're looking for things like that to help facilitate the adjuster's time to be more efficient, more well spent, in terms of, you know, allowing them to do their job, and being more accurate. And I think, you know, when it comes down to quality, they're really in a customer service. And, you know, the tech that's involved in being able to increase customer service, because the margins are quite thin is what we've heard. And so they're really competing for customer base based on experience of the claims. And so when they do have claims, they want to make sure that the experience is really there, because they don't really want to lose that customer or lose that premium. And so our technology, what we heard, is really not there to automate anything. It's not there to, say, take anyone's job. It's there to allow the people that know how to do their job best, make better decisions faster, and be able to go on to the next claim. You know, I think more so than the carriers, the adjusters for the carriers really loving it. As a contractor, when I talk to a staff adjuster, they just want to be able to process these claims as fair as possible, as quickly as possible. And their life passion is not to get in arguments and disputes, right? They just want to, you know, come out here. They're out here for 10, 12 days. And so I believe that our app is really allowing them to diffuse what otherwise could be an escalating problem of building codes. Carriers are embracing this as a technology that assists them in being able to make better decisions faster. We've been working hard figuring out who we're going to be integrating with and when. And I think the integration with Xactware and the integration with Symbility are the best integrations that we could ask for. You know, with those integrations come the ability for direct connection to 90 to 100% of the insurance carriers in the United States. And it's right into their core systems, their claim core systems. And so that there is gonna be something that we really are gonna be cherishing for the years to come, because of the ability for our reports to be able to be integrated into pretty much every claim system. Permitting is the next thing that we're going after. It's so odd that no one has figured out how to do an automation of permitting costs across the country. Turns out that they needed to have the technology that we had, which is jurisdiction having authority to get that right, because every single city and county has their own permit fee calculation. So you gotta know who has authority over that house in order to how to calculate that permit. So, with the launch of the permit, I think that is something that is gonna be very important to the continued efforts of our products rolling out. It's something that we look forward to, with something that we've been wanting to do and something that has been in the works for a while. So one-click code is gonna be on the App Store or Google Play Store. Just type in one-click code. And then also we're at oneclickcode.com. And so we're available both on iOS, Android, and the web. You can check us out on Facebook as well as LinkedIn.
For more information, go to oneclickcode.com. Adjuster TV is the premier video resource for the independent adjusting community, and we are committed to bringing you the best, most up-to-date, and entertaining programming to help you learn what adjusting is all about, if it's right for you, and how to build a rewarding career in claims, a career where you can help people in their time of crisis and earn a great living. For much more information about becoming a successful property or auto claims IA, including many more videos, free tutorials and webinars, the best gear and software for claims, and industry news and IA weather reports, head on over to adjustertv.com. And as always, thank you so much for watching, and have a great storm.